Usually, when I'm buying a car, it involves three things. The auto trader, a biro, and a Tetley's overdose. Then I stare bleakly into the engine bay and try to get 50 quid knocked off the asking price because the doors don't work. But what about the other end of the scale? What if you were buying one of the most exclusive and expensive cars out there? Are you still allowed to kick the tyres? Well, I'm here, dressed like I mean it, to find out. I'm at one of the world's most exclusive dealerships in the heart of fashionable Mayfair to find out what it's like. I'm going shopping for a car of which only 24 were sold in the UK last year. That's right, I'm going to buy a £260,000 Maybach. Though I probably won't actually buy it. A Maybach is an uber-posh Mercedes. People who have already bought one include Simon Cowell, Madonna, and F1 mogul Bernie Eccleston.
I work all night, I work all day to pay the bills I have to pay.
Immediately, you'll realise this isn't quite meeting Big Dave at his lock-up under the arches. The only UK Maybach dealer is secreted at the back of this Merc showroom in the poshest bit of London. The only people who know it's here are those that need to know. To put this into a kind of rich person's perspective, there are six official Rolls-Royce Phantom dealerships in the UK, but only one for Maybach. They call it a centre of excellence, and this is where Britain's richest, or is more often the case their PAs, come to spec more than a quarter of a million pound car. This man is Simon Inglefield. He's the man the pop stars, sheikhs and movie stars come to personalise their Maybach.
We have a variety of different customers that buy the Maybach. It varies from successful industrialists in the UK through to we have some film and pop star type customers, and we have some international business people who have a residence here in the UK and use a Maybach when they're here.
Crikey, just through here.
It's like Star Trek.
Star Trek, but a little better.
Wow.
Some of our customers only have a very short amount of time, sometimes even only 15 minutes, so I have to run through all the options on the Maybach very quickly. Other customers tend to have more time for the car, and they'll allocate maybe an afternoon, so I think by the end of it, everyone's pretty sure of the design they want.
You're younger than some of our customers, so do you enjoy driving as well?
I do, but you know, I want something that I can use perhaps for tooling around town. I don't know, I might buy two.
Okay.
With more than 2.2 million permutations on options, you need all the help you can get. For instance, Simon can match any paint colour you can think of, perhaps to match an existing car or yacht. One Middle Eastern buyer went to great lengths for a matching fleet when he met the Maybach representative at a Berlin airfield in his private jet.
The purpose of taking the jet there was to show him the leather seats in the jet. And that was the style of the colour of the leather and the style of leather he wanted. Once the Maybach guy had seen those colours, he was then waved off the jet and the jet took off.
Should you feel the need to drive, please welcome to have a
Thank
seat
you.
Inside. This car has a 5.5 twin turbo V12 engine.
Thank you.
Which gives you 550 brake horsepower.
Supercar kind of power.
Yeah, 0 to 60 in 5.4 seconds.
That's supercar kind of fast.
And the car's just under 3 tonnes.
That truck.
Okay, so if you'd like to take a seat in the back of the car, and I'll just go on the other side.
Ooh, the door closes itself. That's very cool. Look at this. Silver. Champagne balloons. Silver.
Yes, yeah, that's the silver champagne flutes. It's a little safer to have silver in the car than actual glass.
That's the kind of flash I like.
Obviously, you have all your high-tech equipment in here as well. Your DVD
wow.
Players in here. That's the storage for the champagne flutes when they're not being used, which is very rare, of course.
I feel very comfortable. What are they? Oh, there's a clock?
Yeah, you have your speed on there, so you can keep an eye on what the driver's doing. You have your clock and then your outside temperature. No car will be complete without a fridge.
A fridge? Oh, hang on, I've seen... What's... Oh,
those are
excellent.
Tables.
That's what I need in my life.
Pull it up. That's it.
Oh, that's exactly what we need. I mean, that'd be so useful for all sorts of things, you know, cooking, or a laptop.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that all seems satisfactory.
Wonderful.
I think we ought to go and look at some of the real options, because I'm definitely thinking about buying one. Let's go to it, Simon.
Wonderful.
First, you've got to help me out here, though.
To do things properly, you don't look at brochures. You visit the configurator.
Please come through.
Oh, very James Bond.
Absolutely. This is our Maybach lounge. Mr. Ford, have a seat. Thank you.
The configurator lets you see how your car and options look before you actually go to the expense of ordering. And what the configurator showed me was that you'll run out of money long before you run out of options.
We have diamonds that can be inlaid throughout the interior. Some of our Middle Eastern customers, for example, would choose maybe some gold fixtures and fittings in the car. I guess you could get to £700,000 or £800,000.
Not all the options are so superficial. Some are genuinely useful.
You've got obviously an intercom system between you and the driver. The external communication system is so you can speak to people outside the car.
Excellent.
Obviously, the main use for that would be for, say, a diplomat.
Talking to girls.
Well, you could talk to girls with it, of course. It has a listening device as well, so you can actually... It's a two-way
listen
system.
To girls.
Absolutely.
Brilliant.
Obviously, it's mainly for, say, a diplomat or someone who didn't want to outside the car for any reason to communicate with their staff.
OK. I want a PA system. Definitely for talking to girls. I mean, diplomat things.
OK.
I'd like black hide.
Yeah, we can do that.
Monotone exterior colour with black.
So the single tone.
Single tone.
Single tone colour.
Black with black. Black hide.
Okay, 1 second. The black leather, yeah.
I'd like black windows at the privacy glass, obviously, because if I do go in the back, I don't want the fans to see me. And to be honest, I've actually got to get going. So I'm going to leave the rest to you.
Okay, get that.
And I want massaging seats.
They're standard.
Thank you.
They're standard.
I'm going to go and buy a small foreign country and strip it of its GDP to pay for this. So how long will my car take?
Car takes around 10 to 12 weeks to be built, because the majority of it is hand-finished. So we're looking at about 6 months' time before we can have you behind the wheel of that car.
I'll see you in six.
Wonderful.
You can either buy a very long Maybach 57, the even longer 62, or, like me, the newest and sportiest version, the £290,000 57S. But is it any good?
Now, this version has a 612 horsepower V12 bi-turbo, which means that it's also got a nosebleed 734 pounds-feet of torque. You'd think that would make it fast, and it is. 0 to 62 in under 5 seconds, which is pretty surprising considering this car is the size of my nan's house. All that torque makes this car really responsive. You'd think something this big would be quite lazy, but it's not. One prod of the throttle and it's up an atom. Just watch. Prod, surge. Prod, surge. Very responsive, very cool.
You can't help thinking this does nothing better than any other normal executive saloon. But the fact is, Mercedes-Benz invented the motor car, and they have to be able to lay claim to making the greatest one in the world. And the strongest claim the Bach has for being the best is its silence. Just listen. Nothing. Lovely. And unlike almost every other car in the world, passers-by always look in the back first, which is what I did recently outside the Brit Awards and saw Paris Hilton. If she's into them, then expect every bright young thing to want one too.
Personally, I don't think the Maybach brand is really about this kind of sportiness. You know, the one that makes the most sense to me, because it's ultra-luxury, is the 62. You know, you get that extra metre, you can be in the back and forget about the world.
So, if I was actually going to buy one, I would have to go for an all-black 62 with Paris in the back.